Hello, this is Paul Chek. Welcome back to my video blog. Today I thought I would talk a little bit about erectile dysfunction. So my title today is Tips on Erectile Dysfunction. The reason I'm bringing this up is because in the last several years, probably the last 10 years, I've had quite a stream of young people, particularly between the ages of 16 to 22, oftentimes young athletes who are contacting me or have been clients, as well as people who are couples that cannot get pregnant, either because the man's not producing enough sperm or because of health challenges in the wife or both of them, but there's erectile dysfunction correlations in those cases where couples can't get pregnant due to the same things we're going to talk about with erectile dysfunction here. So in other words, what I'm saying is if you have erectile dysfunction, you will already have the kinds of problems that will stop you as a male from being able to get a woman pregnant if that's what you want to do, which is a pretty serious indicator of poor health because the male body puts all of its resources into producing the best sperm that it can as a means of enhancing your survival. So when a man's sperm count starts to drop down due to diet and lifestyle factors, it also means that the quality of his sperm is going to drop down as well, so you end up getting the kinds of problems in reproduction that were clearly demonstrated in Pottinger's study called Pottinger's Cats. And there's a book called Pottinger's Cats by Francis Marion Pottinger that shows exactly what I'm talking about. But basically what he showed is that processed food eating leads to what he called a germ spore injury, which is an older medical term for injury to the DNA. So you start seeing kids that are born with all sorts of health problems, missing a kidney, body shape problems, physiological problems, and you know, things that are very, very stressful, not only for the child, but for a new parent. It's quite a shock to me that we're having so many young people with this problem simply because it's usually considered a problem that happens to men once they hit about 50 and onward due to aging and just the accumulation of life stress and poor self-management. So to be having this problem so frequently in young people who should be very, very vibrant and vital in their teen years is an indication that our culture is essentially breaking down, and most cultures in the world are having these problems. I get these kinds of contacts about erectile dysfunction, not just from the United States, but from all over the world. And as I said, it's been going on quite a bit in the last 10 years. So today I want to just cover some of the key things that we need to be aware of that are directly linked to the problem, and they're things that I not only work with regularly in my professional practice as a holistic health practitioner, but they're also things that I've trained all my holistic health practitioners in the HLC program how to address. So anyone that has this problem and wants help with it could easily go to checkconnect.com and find a Czech holistic lifestyle coach level 2 or 3 near you. Many of them will work with you on Skype, so you can get help from anywhere in the world and they can coach you on how to apply many of the things that I will address, but in much greater detail. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at the basic hormone pathways that are directly related to erectile dysfunction. I've had to simplify this to make it presentable to a public audience and to fit on my board. Then we're going to look at Ken Wilber's 4-quadrant model, which is the basis of my new holistic coaching program, which is specifically designed to teach practitioners of all types. I built it with the emphasis on Czech practitioners, but it's designed so that people from any walk of life that are involved in guiding, coaching, or being a therapist or a doctor for other people could come learn the science and art of coaching people holistically. In other words, looking at the whole person. And I bring that up here not because it's directly related, the coaching program is directly related to erectile dysfunction, but the coaching program is designed as first and foremost a self-healing program. So if you were to come to the Chek Holistic Coaching Training Program, though you would be getting trained to be a professional coach, you would also be going through the exact process that I take people that come to me with erectile dysfunction through to address everything we're going to talk about here and more than I can talk about here in the class. So what I'm saying is the new Chek Holistic Coaching Program, which is different than Chek Holistic Lifestyle Coaching because it's the science and art of coaching people, guiding people through change, transition, and life challenges to grow consciousness, is a program that helps you address exactly what's going on if you want to take that route. Now, what I've done is simplified some of the information right out of my book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy. So your first tip, if you have erectile dysfunction or you know someone that is suffering from it and want to give them a resource, is my book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy, which begins with a series of questionnaires that identify which key body systems are under too much stress for your physiology to function ideally, and guide you to the chapters to teach you how to lower those stress scores. And it includes many different functional tests you can do on your body to see if it's working correctly, corrective exercises, and it gives you specific exercise programs as examples of what you should be doing if your stress levels are too high. So there's a total column and it adds your stress levels up. And based on those stress levels, it gives you an exercise program that's ideal to not only help bring the stress down, but nourish your body instead of beating your body up. My audio recordings and my multimedia ebook, The Last Four Doctors You'll Ever Need, gives you an explanation of the basics of my 1-2-3-4 format, which is a beautiful complement to How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy. Both of these resources are essential if you want to heal from erectile dysfunction. So let's begin our little journey here. First, what you see here is I've broken up, these represent plates that you put your food on. And these are the three basic types. So Bill Walcott is quite famous for his approach to metabolic typing. So he uses fast oxidizer, slow oxidizer, mixed oxidizer. There's many different systems of metabolic typing. What I did is I simplified my system down specifically to make it work with the rest of the Chek training and also based on my own experiences of metabolic typing. So I basically created what I call primal pattern typing. In my system of primal pattern typing, you have three basic types. The polar type are people whose genes come from somewhere where the earth freezes in the winter and vegetables don't grow in the winter, so those people genetically need more flesh foods or they cannot effectively produce enough cortisol. Not everyone can make the hormones they need or extract certain nutrients from plant-based foods, which is one of the key things when it comes to belief systems like vegetarianism, veganism, etc., or religious applications of those things. They overlook that we have unique genetic needs, and those genetic needs are largely based on the environment that we're in. In other words, the way an Eskimo eats is going to be genetically influenced by the environment, and it will not be the same as an inland Aboriginal or a Southern Californian, for that matter. A mixed type is someone who is probably got parents with genes from the polar or the equator type. The equator type means anybody who lives in regions where it's generally warmer, so near the equator. As you go from the poles toward the equator, you have more of availability of things, particularly in the winter. In California, you can see all sorts of stuff growing in the winter that would never grow in the colder regions of the planet. So here you have things like your Mediterranean diet would be very equator-like. In the equator category, you're generally looking at around 60% of a person's meal or two servings of plant food relative to one serving of animal food. These are generalizations. You always have to fine-tune based on each meal. And my webinar recording on primal pattern dieting shows you exactly the techniques I teach HLC students to the best I could teach them in that format, but it gives you techniques for individualizing each meal to get what you need. So here you got about a ratio of approximately 2 servings of vegetable food to 1 serving of flesh food. Here you have half and half. Here you have 2 servings of flesh food to approximately 1 serving of plant food. And again, these are just generalizations to show you the groupings. They can vary. In fact, from testing myself and countless other people, I can tell you that we can actually be either one of these types at any point during the day. You could be a polar type or a protein type at breakfast, a mixed type at lunch, and an equator type at dinner, all depending on both internal stress perception and environmental stress factors. So your body's very, very dynamic no matter who you are. So there's no such thing as the right diet for anybody. There is such a thing as paying attention and learning to have a relationship with your body so you know when you're getting various symptoms or emotional shifts or mental performance changes, what that relates to in your diet and lifestyle, and then you adjust. If you stick to some book or some recipe, you're going to box yourself right into problems, and I spend my life unboxing those things. So the point I'm making here is that the ratio of foods that you eat has a huge influence on the availability of cholesterol and the ability to manufacture all these other hormones we're going to look at, which are derivatives of cholesterol. All hormones have an amino acid component in them. So anyone that's protein deficient will have hormonal problems, just as sure as I'm bald-headed. Okay? Now, there's a key thing we want to pay attention to here because it applies almost everywhere on the board. And you could say that's the QQR formula. Quantity, quality, and ratio. What is the quantity of a given thing, the quality of a given thing, and the ratio that you're using it in? So we'll look at that Paul Chek QQR formula as it relates to nutrition, hydration, sleep, breathing, and drinking, and movement, because those things all have an effect on whether or not your body's having a stress response or not. So nutrition, we talked about. With nutrition, you not only get the ratio right, but the quantity has to be right and the quality has to be right. So if you're overeating or undereating, you're going to have problems. If your quality is not good, you're going to have problems. Poor quality food means poor quality nutrients, and poor quality food usually means high doses of toxicity. If you're not using certified organic food, simply, you're poisoning your body and you're funding the companies that are destroying the planet. And when you got 18-year-olds having erectile dysfunction, you got serious problems in society, I can tell you that. When you're 18 years of age, your dick should be so hard it's like steel. You could use it as a dinner bell and call the girls in for chow before a lovely, exciting evening. But this isn't what's going on out there, unfortunately. So nutrition, hydration. Are you getting enough water? Half your body weight in ounces a day. Are you getting good quality water? And is the ratio of minerals or total dissolved solids to water ideal? As I show in my book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy, I got a whole section on water. Your total dissolved solids and water, in my opinion, should be 300 or greater, but you can adjust that using a pinch of high quality Celtic sea salt or New Zealand sea salt and follow the directions in the book. But water is a very, very important factor in the overall regulation and production of hormones. If you don't have adequate quality of water, quantity of water, and you don't use the right ratio of minerals, then you end up having more stress factors that contribute to the overall picture that leads to erectile dysfunction. Sleep, it has to be the right quality. You have to get a good deep sleep. You have to follow the directions in my chapter here on sleep, such as electronics, lighting, many other things like that. Sleep is your number one source of restoring life force energy, and it's very common for people with erectile dysfunction to have sleep deprivation or have problems sleeping. Even if they're getting enough, they're not getting a deep enough sleep because of many things such as electromagnetic pollution, sound pollution, electronics, etc. So we have nutrition, we have hydration, we have sleep, quality, quantity, and then when it comes to the ratio of sleep, the ratio of sleep relates to the 24-hour circadian cycle. If you don't go to bed early enough, by 10 o'clock ideally, then the ratio of waking to sleeping is out of balance with the natural flow of hormonal tides, which is governed by the sun, the moon, and the earth at large. So if you don't follow that ratio of sleep, you can really screw yourself up. And many people come to me telling me, oh, I'm getting 8 hours of sleep at night, but I look at their diet and lifestyle log, I see them going to bed at midnight or 1 o'clock and getting up later in the morning, but they don't realize their hormonal system is governed by the influence of the sun largely and the moon, not what's on television or surfing the internet. So you can easily give yourself erectile dysfunction by not getting the right sleep ratio relative to the cycles of the hormonal system and the body's physiological repair, which again is all addressed in my book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy. Okay? Breathing is critical. So you see these are blue because there's the yin feminine factors. Breathing, thinking, and movement are generally yang, expressive. Breathing oxygenates the body, which allows oxidization, which is a yang process of creating energy. So your breathing has to be ideal. There's many factors that disrupt breathing. The most common factor that disrupts breathing is the consumption of processed sugar or eating too much sugar for your metabolic type. Sugar acidifies the bloodstream, which causes the body to hyperventilate, which then disrupts biochemistry and leads to energetic problems, one of which can be erectile dysfunction. Thinking, research shows that about 80% or more, about 90% of our thoughts are negatively oriented. Deepak Chopra cited research saying the average person thinks about 68,000 thoughts a day, 90% of which have negative orientation. So if your head's full of negative orientation, you're going to disrupt your body's going to react to the stress you're generating for yourself internally. So we have to look at the quality of thoughts, the quantity of thoughts, and the ratio between dream affirmative and dream negative. And I teach you in my holistic lifestyle coaching training, right from HLC 1 all the way through, how to learn to effectively not only manage your own mind, but coach other people to do so, as well as in my new coaching program. And then movement. So quality of movement, is it the right kind of exercise for you, and is it functional? Quantity of movement, too much overstresses you, too little produces stress because you get so weak that even just walking around in the field of gravity becomes overtraining. So you've got the quality of movement, the quantity of movement, and the ratio is how much working out versus working in do you need to do relative to the types of stress. My book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy, teaches you how to use zone exercises, which are energy cultivating exercises, so you have more healing capacity and can balance your hormonal system. And we call that working in my system. So all these factors have an influence on how much cholesterol you can use to produce the sex hormones or androgens or anabolic tissue building, growth, and repair hormones, of which your sex hormones fall into that category. Cholesterol is a base substance which produces pregnenolone. Pregnenolone is the precursor to things like DHEA, testosterone, estrogens, and anabolic sex hormones as a general rule. So there would be some exceptions, but we can't go into that great detail here, but this is reliable as it is. Pregnenolone is also a precursor to progesterone. Progesterone is a precursor to all your glucocorticoid hormones, which are your chief stress hormones. This pathway is referred to by my teacher, Dr. Bill Timmons, who was a master at all this and owns Biohealth Diagnostics. He's gone now, but he was a fantastic teacher, a naturopathic physician who did a lot to evolve hormone testing and salivary testing and all sorts of stuff. He called this pregnenolone steal. He showed that a normal person steals about 60% of their pregnenolone on a daily basis. That's a healthy person, to produce stress hormones and mineral corticoid hormones, which are fluid regulators in the body, all of the fluids, and have many, many key functions that are essential to your survival, such as, you know, for example, when you're, if you're skipping meals and you're starving yourself, you'll notice your body starts to hold water because your mineral corticoids want to keep more water on board because your body thinks you're going to battle or something. So the mineral corticoid hormones are very, very important. If you're drinking the wrong quality, quantity, and ratio of water, you will stress your fluid systems and you'll get a mineral corticoid response. So we have to look at all these factors. Now, what happens in people that I see very, very commonly, in fact, I've never seen someone with erectile dysfunction that didn't have this, they were stealing more, far more than 60% of the pregnenolone to produce progesterone, to produce stress hormones due to the imbalances in these factors and the ones we're going to discuss. So anytime you're eating wrong or living out of balance, you're going to take so much of the pregnenolone that your body has to shut down these anabolic hormones and sex hormones. And it's actually a defense mechanism because the body does not want you to reproduce in an environment that's stressful enough to cause you not to be able to effectively meet your basic biological and survival needs. It would just be suicide. So what you see is that whenever there's more stress in the body than is ideal for reproduction to be effective, for evolution to have a better chance, it shuts these pathways down in order to serve your stress reaction pathways or your stress response pathways so you can fight, flight, or freeze. This pathway is related to four Fs: fight, flight, freeze, and fornicate. But the fornication can't happen if the environment's too stressful, and because if it does, we increase the risk of more, shall we say, failures in the genetic experiment called evolution. Okay? So in a nutshell, erectile dysfunction comes from poor quality, quantity, and ratio of nutrition, hydration, sleep, breathing, thinking, and movement, the six foundation principles taught in the Czech holistic lifestyle coaching system. This is the pathways. Lack of these hormones leads to erectile dysfunction because they're being diverted into the stress hormone pathways due to mostly very common and easy to fix things that I address in my book, How to Eat, Move, and Be Healthy, The Last Four Doctors You'll Ever Need, and the resources that I will share with you. Now, we've